Hello everyone in Medical Scribe. I'm Karar Haider, student at Baghdad Medical College. In the previous video, we talked about the sebaceous glands and we explained almost all details about them. And also, we talked about the sebum, which is the material that is produced by the sebocytes in the sebaceous gland. All that were in the previous video. While today we will talk about the third element in the skin appendages, which is the sweat gland. The sweat gland is a long, tubular, and coiled-shaped structure. Let's explain this phrase. We say that the sweat gland, which is the gland that secretes sweat, is a long structure and a tubular in nature because it's composed of tubules. And it's coiled-shaped because it's wrapped around itself. These glands extend throughout the full thickness of the dermis layer, which means they will begin, for example, from the skin surface, extending down, reaching the lower end of the dermis, and may reach the superficial fascia. So from that, we can conclude that the sweat gland is the deepest structure of all the skin appendages. Alright, the greatest concentration of this sweat gland is in the thick skin of the palm of the hand and the sole of the feet and also in the face. So, if we need to classify the sweat glands according their types, they will be classified into two major types, which are the eccrine sweat glands and the apocrine sweat glands. These two types differ in their structure and in their function, mode of excretion of their products, and also in their anatomic distribution. And now we will take a general look about these types, because in the upcoming videos, we dive in the details. Regarding the eccrine sweat glands, they will open directly on the skin surface, and they are the most common type which distributed all over the body, except the lips and external genitalia. While the apocrine sweat glands, they will open on the hair follicle, not on the skin surface, and we will find them mostly in the scalp and in the armpit, in the nipple and areola, and in the external genitalia. Okay, now let's move forward and talk about the structure of a sweat gland. In general, every sweat gland composed of two major parts, the secretory unit which produces sweat, and the duct which carries the sweat away. So the secretory unit, which is the first part, considers as the base of the gland, and it exists in the lower dermis. This unit is surrounded by myoepithelial cells, which look like muscle in their contractility. These myoepithelial cells, and because of its contractility, will help when contract and excrete the sweat, because it will squeeze the gland. And keep in your mind that the sweat production process and this cell contraction is regulated by the autonomic nervous system and the hormones. While the duct, which is the last thing we have, is the second part of the sweat gland structure. This duct will act as a drainage canal that carries the sweat from the secretory unit to the skin surface. So these were almost everything about the sweat glands. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.